Live from Fargo and serving you on TV, online, and on the go. This is Valley News Live at 5.
We begin with breaking news involving a hostile work environment complaint filed against Cass County Social Services. A former employee claims that working conditions are hostile towards staff. A special meeting has been called regarding the allegations made by Jennifer Aldinger, who resigned earlier this year. Valley News Team's Mike Morkin joins us now live with details of her complaint. Mike?
Andrea, Jennifer Aldinger says that she was once told by a supervisor in the Child Protection Services Unit to keep her head down and her mouth shut and do as you were told. She accuses CPS management of ethical violations for holding off on assigning cases for over 2 weeks after receiving them. These are just two of the findings to surface in a Cass County Sheriff's investigation. It also showed that Aldinger went to HR for assistance for what she called inappropriate conduct on the part of Rick Van Camp and Linda Dorf. And in her letter of resignation, she said it was due to the appalling behavior exhibited by management of Family Services Department, adding that Cass County's blatant disregard for the safety and well-being of children and families they have been entrusted to serve is something that she could not feel that she could continue to be part of. All of this and more will be considered during that special meeting of the Cass County Social Services Board on Monday, October 21st. Andrea?
All right. Thank you, Mike. In her allegations, Aldinger also cited an unmanageable amount of cases assigned to staff and how they led to the hostile work conditions. You can look for more on this tonight on Valley News Live 10 at 10. We are barely into October and we're seeing this. A little hard to see, though. It's the first snow of the season. Those little sparkles you see on your screen, light snow and fog. That's our sky cam in Dickinson. Other towns in western North Dakota have flakes, too. The snow is moving through the state, expected to hit our viewing area a little later. At least it's melting when it hits the ground, right? Let's find out more from Hutch in your no-way weather. Hutch?
Well, here in the FM area, we have dark skies, and from time to time, a drizzle drop makes its way down to the ground. But as we look to the southern Red River Valley, we see a batch of rain moving through Richland and Sargent counties. It's all spreading to the north and east. Some heavier showers of rain pushing into the Grand Forks area from Grand Forks and Nelson counties south through Griggs, Steele, and northern parts of Barnes County. The blue that you see on the radar, will remind you, is where the radar is indicating some flakes of snow, winter weather advisories out there. And we have already measured up to 3 inches of snow in southwesternmost parts of North Dakota. Where you see the deep blue color just off to the east of Dickinson, some larger flakes being picked up by the radar. This snow spreading to the north and east toward the Devil's Lake Basin. Here's a shot of Highway 8 near Mott, southwest of Bismarck. For us tonight, a very good chance of rain. Most of our viewing area has a good chance of getting some very measurable rain. Coming up here in the forecast, we'll detail about how much rainfall we expect and who in our viewing area will have the best chance of snow, mainly to the north and west. Details in your hour-by-hour forecast coming up in just a few moments.
All right, we'll see you soon, Hutch. Thank you. That shocking video was captured on a North Fargo doorbell camera yesterday evening in the 1100 block of 7th Street North. And today, neighbors in the area told Valley News Team's crime and safety reporter, Bailey Hurley, that they believe the car was going at least 70 miles an hour, adding it's a miracle no one was hurt or killed.
It's a video that stuns even those who've seen it all.
You can hear them. Sounds like motorcycles. Oh, wow. It's a little reckless, especially in a neighborhood, 25 miles per hour.
But it's especially shocking for those here living on the block.
I said, that sounds like he's going crazy fast. And then all of a sudden we see out of this window just this blue car flash by. And I mean, it was there and gone in the blink of an eye.
Both Johnson and his roommate say speedsters like this usually aren't a problem for their quiet Roosevelt neighborhood.
There's a lot of people biking, walking across the street. So, I mean, you got to go slow in there to be safe, to be honest.
Could you imagine if somebody had, like, not looked or didn't hear it or something and walked up? Like, they would be very, very long gone. Like, that would have been awful.
And while it is clear the driver is whizzing by at dangerous speeds, Fargo police say there's not much they can do, as traffic violations must actually be witnessed by an officer.
They can't just pull him over because of something they saw in a video that happened at a different time.
Schindeldecker says videos and tips like this are helpful to the department, but that doesn't mean finding those responsible will be easy.
It's really frustrating for people in our community when they see this happening, but we're not able to catch it because we can't, you know, you don't know exactly what day, what time they're going to do this, and if they're going to continue to do it at the same intersection or area.
Neighbors tell me they hope this is just a one-time thing, saying most of all, they're just glad no one was hurt. In North Fargo, Bailey Hurley, Valley News Live.
If you've seen this vehicle speeding in your neighborhood, let us know on our Facebook page. Police in West Central Minnesota are investigating after a man took his own life on the way to jail. It happened in Swift County on Monday. The sheriff's department says a 62-year-old man from Benson shot himself while he was being driven to the jail to surrender to authorities. The person driving the car called 911 when it happened. The man was wanted for being a felon in possession of ammunition. Authorities say it's been nearly three decades since a man was reported missing in Fargo, and police are still looking for information on the case. The Fargo Police Department says Kevin Mahoney disappeared on October 2nd, 1993. Again, the department is still investigating and wants anyone with information on Mahoney's disappearance to come forward. We will have more on this story tonight on Valley News Live at 6. Fargo police are warning the public of a scam where homeless people are cashing in fraudulent checks as part of a nationwide ring. The scheme is named Operation Homeless, and the scam involves an out-of-state group driving to Fargo in rental cars and breaking into mailboxes overnight. The group takes checks, specifically those written for high dollar amounts, and then recruits suspects. The total face value of the stolen checks was more than $100,000. According to court records, the suspects were able to cash eight checks in Fargo worth more than $52,000. Fargo police are warning of a new internet scam that's hitting the valley called flipping. Police say it's mostly hitting Snapchat users, with scammers promising to give you a large amount of cash if you pay them first.
So they're trying to entice people to give them $200 and will promise you that you will make it $2,000. And that's kind of one of those it's too good to be true type of scams. And you should really do your due diligence to look into it. And those types of scams, those are scams that are basically you're going to be out $200 if you give it to them.
Fargo police remind you to never give out your PIN numbers and always be careful when paying others on apps like Venmo and Cash App. House Speaker Nancy Pelosi called President Trump's actions surrounding Ukraine a, quote, assault on the Constitution, leaving her no alternative but to start an impeachment inquiry. The speaker told reporters the inquiry is a very sad time for America, and she's committed to being fair to the president. But Intelligence Committee Chair Adam Schiff says Democrats are not fooling around and want the impeachment inquiry wrapped up sooner rather than later. Pelosi and Schiff outlined a series of actions by the administration they find highly problematic.
Let's not make any mistake here. The president wants to make this all about the whistleblower and suggest people that come forward with evidence of his wrongdoing are somehow treasonous and should be treated as traitors and spies. This is a blatant effort to intimidate witnesses.
The Intelligence Committee is conducting depositions and closed-door hearings through next week while Congress is on break. Officials close to Senator Bernie Sanders say he is doing well after having a medical procedure on his heart. The Sanders campaign issued a statement this morning that says Sanders experienced some chest discomfort Tuesday evening. Doctors found a blockage in one artery and inserted two stents. The statement goes on to say that the 78-year-old is talking and in good spirits. All of Sanders' events and appearances have been canceled until further notice. Today, a Dallas County jury sentenced former police officer Amber Geiger to 10 years in prison after being found guilty of murder yesterday. We have new video of the former officer in jail. Geiger's mugshot was taken Tuesday after a jury found her guilty of murder in the shooting death of her neighbor, Botham Jean. She was booked into the Dallas County Jail just before 5 Tuesday evening. Geiger shot and killed the 26-year-old in his apartment last September. Geiger says she thought she was in her apartment and that she shot him in self-defense. October marks the start of flu season, and 15 cases of the flu have already been reported in North Dakota, four of them in Cass County. And if you thought getting a flu shot is going to help, think again. Valley News Team's Callie Hubbard explains.
The flu shot debate goes back and forth. Either you're on board with it, it usually keeps me from getting sick every year, or you're not.
I think that it's kind of a thing that people don't necessarily need.
And this might make you a little wary when getting a flu shot. Experts meet twice a year. The Northern Hemisphere, that's us, meet in February to predict the dominant strand for the upcoming year. And the Southern Hemisphere just met in September. What surfaced was that two of the four viruses in our vaccines may not protect you this year.
I don't really know
know how to feel about it, but we all have different strains every year, so you can't really depict them all.
Local health experts say it's too early to tell.
Just because what happens in the southern hemisphere doesn't necessarily translate to the northern hemisphere.
Even if getting the flu vaccine isn't a guarantee, experts say it's better to be safe than sorry.
Why do you get it?
Because I want to prevent my residents. I don't want them to get sick. And I don't want to get sick too.
Others are still not buying it.
If you're going to get the flu, you're going to get the flu, and it kind of helps your body fight off other bacteria that you're going
to
have.
And if you're looking to get your flu shot, Fargo Cass Public Health says it's probably best to do so before October 31st. In Fargo, Callie Hubbard, Valley News 5.
To learn more on flu symptoms and where to get the vaccine, you can head to our website, valleynewslive.com. And a reminder to join us this week at 11 a.m. for the Farmers Union Insurance Bison Football pregame show. We'll take you right up to kickoff at noon between the Bison and the Redbirds, live on the KVLY and KFYR Bison Football Network.